Hey everybody, Antoni here with a review of Rossini Semiramide, which I saw at the Bayerische Staatsoper. The conductor was Michele Mariotti, the production was done by David Alden, the sets were done by Paul Steinberg, the costumes were done by Buki Schiff, the videographer was Robert Pflanz, the choreographer was Beate Follack, the lights were handled by Michael Bauer, the dramaturgy was handled by Daniel Menne, the chorus master was Delario Fagonne, and the assistant director was Frauke Mayer. I was anticipating this particular production of Semiramide because of the leading stars, basically that of Joyce DiDonato, Daniele Barcellona, Lawrence Brownlee, Alex Esposito, and Simone Alberghini. I'll gladly get to their performance much later, but first, my thoughts on the production. What I noticed about this production of Semiramide is that the people behind it transported the action from ancient Babylon all the way up to, I would say, the 20th century Middle East, in which we see a lot of people wearing not only suits and the soldiers wearing a lot of the typical military clothing, but we also see women wearing hijabs and veils and a lot of the typical Middle Eastern clothing. And I also have to say that the backgrounds are really intricate. A lot of the backgrounds are colorful and they just look really gorgeous to look at. And I also love the ending of this particular opera production because even though Arsace has killed his own mother and was almost about to kill Assur, though Assur ended up arrested, it's basically an ongoing cycle of violence which Arsace has gotten himself into. And here's a few funny things about this production, especially one in particular. We also get to see Azzema wearing all gold, and the usual running gag is that she would usually be carried off by someone off stage after she's done with her ensemble work or her duets. What would usually happen is that she would get carried off stage. And speaking of the costumes, it's not just Azzema's gold costume I really like. I also love Semiramide's choices of costumes. We get to see her wearing all black, and I really love her costume when she is seen in public as the queen. And a lot of the costumes that Semiramide wears look very elegant on her. And what's also interesting about Arsace's costume is that he first enters the scene wearing some type of armor, which basically covers his pine green military suit. It's basically to show that he has his roots based on his ancestors, which I found rather interesting. So overall, the production and costumes were gorgeous and quite interesting in their own special way. And they were also quite mesmerizing in terms of the designs. And I also love the video scenes, which also showed the ghost of Nino haunting everyone. And the lighting especially is so well done. So I have to give a huge amount of kudos to the people behind the production and costumes for a job excellently done. And now we get to the singers. This was pretty much, in my opinion, the Joyce DiDonato and Daniela Barcellona show, because these two exceptional ladies pretty much stole the show with their technical prowess and their overall dedication as great singing actresses. But that's just the short answer. Now we get to the specifics, starting off with Joyce DiDonato, who was tonight's Semiramide. At first, I was quite skeptical because Joyce DiDonato is a coloratura mezzo. And if you know me, I always love it when a high-singing, true dramatic coloratura soprano sings this particular role. I always think of voices like Joan Sutherland and what we even have today with the likes of Jessica Pratt and Albina Shagimuratova taking over the role of Semiramide in different opera venues. And even though Joyce DiDonato isn't really a dramatic coloratura soprano, she's more of a coloratura mezzo, I have to say that her overall commitment to her craft as a bel canto singer and her gifts as a talented singing actress and her overall commitment just goes to show you how much of a grand artist Joyce DiDonato really is. I really enjoy her singing. I enjoy everything that she had to offer as the titular heroine. She looked absolutely gorgeous. She not only sang the part, but she looked the part. She was elegant. She was dignified. She knew how to find all of those layers which make Semiramide a very interesting, complex, and quite entertaining of a character to witness. She was wonderful in her aria Bel Raggio Lusinghier and also her duets with the Arsace, Daniela Barcellona. So overall, Joyce DiDonato was not only in tip-top great form as Semiramide, but she continues to prove herself to be one of the finest singing actresses I have ever seen. Thanks to her homogeneous and versatile voice, which can reach certain heights, and also thanks to her magnetic stage presence. Equally as magnetic was Daniela Barcellona, who sang the role of Arsace. I followed this particular mezzo-soprano's career for quite some time, and much like her predecessors being Marilyn Horn and Lucia Valentini Terragni, she not only specializes in the bel canto roles of Rosina from Barbieri di Siviglia, Angelina from Cenerentola, Isabella from L'Italiana in Algeri, and even Giovanna Seymour from Anna Bolena, but she also specializes in a lot more dramatic mezzo roles, like her engagements as Carmen, Dalila, Dulcinée from Jules Massenet's Don Quixote, Amneris, Eboli, and even Mistress Quickly. So the fact that she is a versatile, dramatic coloratura mezzo, though nowadays she is heading towards the more dramatic mezzo route, is something to really behold. And lest I forget, she also sang the dramatic soprano role of Santuzza, making her quite awe-inspiring. And when it comes to Daniela Barcellona's voice, I definitely love it. It has that full, rich, and cavernously luscious timbre that I love in many a dramatic mezzo. Her stage presence is extremely magnetic. She is totally believable as a young man who is battle-hardened, strong, and determined. She was able to bring out all of those characters of Arsace to life, and it's also helped with her skilled and masterful singing, which she manages to pull off exceptionally. And like I stated before, her chemistry with Joyce DiDonato as the long-lost mother, Semiramide, is extremely palpable. One can feel the growing tension these two characters have, at first starting off as something that involves being in love with each other, while even though Arsace has his feelings for Azzema, to realizing that Semiramide is not only his mother, but Semiramide also had a paramour in the form of Assur. So Arsace feels like there is this heavy burden occurring not only between him, but also his mother and his reputation as the future king. And Daniela Barcellona really does play all of these aspects exceptionally. She and Joyce DiDonato were very much the huge stars of the evening. And what about the other players? Well, they were also exceptional. Lawrence Brownlee was, simply put, a fine Prince Idreno. I've also followed this particular tenor's career for quite some time, and he's also a bel canto specialist, singing roles like Alma Viva from Barbieri di Siviglia, Lindoro from L'Italiana in Algeri, Ramiro from Cenerentola, Le Comte Henri from, of course, Le Comte Henri, and Tonio from La Fille du Régiment, and even Arturo from I Puritani and Elvino from La Sonnambula. This gentleman, much like a lot of his contemporaries being Celso Arbello, Javier Camarena, and even Juan Diego Flores, has specialized in singing a lot of these youthful, leggero type roles, and his upper register is equally as impressive as what I've heard tonight. Yes, his voice is not a very powerful voice, but it's a gorgeous, supple, and just a wonderful instrument all throughout. And his stage presence was equally dashing. I definitely felt it. His vocal presence being so dashing and charming and full of determination. And at the same time, he embodied the role of Prince Idreno with nobility and a sort of fiery disposition that he managed to play off of really well. Then we also go to Alex Esposito as Azur. And I also heard this particular gentleman in roles like Papageno, Leporello, and a lot of other comic roles. And he even specializes in some dramatic roles like Enrico from Anna Bolena, and even that of Alfonso d'Este from Donizetti's Lucrezia Borgia. And he's even going to sing Mephistopheles from Gounod's Faust at the Deutsche Oper Berlin next year. That's how much of a versatile singer Signore Esposito really is. And while he may not have the uber cavernous notes of, let's say, Vladimiro Ganzarolli or Joseph Rollo, who also sang the role of Arsur, Alex Esposito managed to sing his role wonderfully, helped with great theatricality and an overall understanding of how sleazy this character can be and how much guilt Azur will have, especially in the final parts of the opera and his eventual villain breakdown. He is a charismatic performer from beginning to end, and I can definitely tell that he had a lot of fun embodying this particular character. Simone Alberghini was in fine voice singing the role of the High Priest Oroe. And what's also interesting about Simone Alberghini is that he's also been specializing in a lot of dramatic baritone roles, like Conte di Luna from Trovatore and Marcello from La Bohème. I'm sure that in the past he also sang a good deal of basso roles, mostly from the bel canto repertoire, and he even sings the likes of Don Giovanni. When I heard his voice, it basically does sound like a bass baritone, and that's pretty much also the same case with Alex Esposito. Both Signore Esposito and Signore Alberghini are essentially bass baritones. And with Simone Alberghini, he did a fine job singing the role of Oroe. Granted, I would have loved to have a much smoother, rounder, richer tone, especially when it comes to having voices like Jerome Hines, Cesare Siepi, Giorgio Tozzi, Nikolai Gyourov, and Bonaldo Giotti, and even to some extent Ezio Flagello, and of course, if you want to go much earlier, Ezio Pinza and Alexander Kipnis, whose voices are pretty much in my head when it comes to hearing great basso cantante voices. Yet in terms of Signore Alberghini, I thought he sounded solidly. He managed to act the part with a great amount of dignity, and he was quite tall on stage. All in all, Simone Alberghini was a solid Oroe, with a fine voice and a dignified stage presence. We even have such great singing from Igor Tsarkov's haunting Ghost of Nina, Galeano Salas's gorgeously tuned and handsome Mitrane, and of course, the one who definitely stole the show when it comes to minor characters was a fabulous young lyric coloratura soprano by the name of Nicola Hillebrand, who sang the role of Atsema, and I thought she looked lovely and sounded lovely as well. She has a sweet and light voice, and I would love to hear her in a lot more roles in the near future. So overall, this was definitely a great evening for all of the singers, especially when you have two great professionals like Joyce DiDonato and Daniela Barcellona, who did exceptionally and were the absolute standouts of the evening. And the conducting done by Michele Mariotti was well done. He really made sure that the orchestra played not only briskly when they needed to, but also made sure that they had a certain amount of nuance to their playing. And he made sure that all the singers and all of the chorus members went together wonderfully. And of course, the chorus and orchestra of the Bayerische Staatsoper were exceptional. So overall, Joyce DiDonato and Daniela Barcellona stood extremely tall when it comes to this great cast of soloists. But I also have to give a great amount of kudos to Lawrence Brownlee, Alex Esposito, Simone Alberghini, Nicola Hillebrand, Galliano Salas, and Igor Tsarkov for jobs excellently done in roles that really were tailor-made for their voices. And I can definitely tell that everyone had a great amount of fun in this wonderful production. And for those of you who saw this particular production of Rossini's Semiramide at the Bayerische Staatsoper, what did you think of it? Did you feel like Joyce DiDonato and Daniela Barcellona were the absolute standouts when it comes to the soloists? Did you feel like there was another soloist who stole their thunder? Or did you feel like the singing was not really up to par? Comment below and let me know. Well, that's all for now. Be sure to tune in tomorrow for my review of Verdi's Otello, which is live streamed from the Royal Opera House, as it stars Jonas Kaufmann singing Otello alongside Maria Agresta as Desdemona. So until then, good night, everybody.